So we're going to look at this advisory for COVID-19 testing during the second wave of pandemic. So the Indian Council of Medical Research has come up with this latest advisory. It is an advisory to the center and the state and everybody else. And this is based on the new surge in the cases of coronavirus or COVID-19. Now, right now, it says that the nationwide test positivity rate is above 20%. That means that if 10 people are going for testing, 2 are coming corona positive. Now that is a high number according to standards. Now, because of that, what is happening? The laboratories are facing challenges to meet the expected testing target due to extraordinary case load. Now, what does that mean? That means that at current situation, you know, because of the extraordinary load and because of the staff who do the testing getting infected, there is a huge load on the labs and testing. You know, earlier it used to come within 24 hours. Now people are getting tests within after, you know, like days. So we have to look at this as a national wide problem and how to, you know, optimize this situation. There are points given here. The first is that if somebody has been already tested positive by a rapid antigen test. So there are two types of corona tests. Number one is a rapid antigen test, which gives you result within 15 to 20 minutes. And there is RT-PCR, which has a runtime. You know, usually it is done in 12 hours, but usually labs give you a time of 24 hours for the result to come out and for it to be analyzed and printed and given to you. So it says that anybody testing positive in a rapid antigen test does not require to go for a RT-PCR test. Anybody tested positive in a RT-PCR, of course, for any, you know, clarification or confirmation, does not require another test. And no testing is required as per the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare guidelines once a patient is discharged from the hospital. Then the need for RT-PCR test in healthy individuals. So this is very important. Right now, states are saying, please enter the state with COVID negative certificate. Please enter the state with COVID negative certificate. So ICMR is requesting, that advising, that all the states should do away, totally do away with the need for an RT-PCR test in healthy individuals, you know. And, you know, this will completely, this should be completely removed because this will reduce the load on the laboratories. Then it also, in your important points, as you can read, you're like taking the important points, these individuals who are asymptomatic, you know, and people who have symptoms, they should not travel. They should essentially avoid travel, especially the symptomatic individuals. The asymptomatic ones should travel, you know, with all the COVID appropriate behavior. Mobile testing labs, the ICMR says, should be, you know, bought by the states, so that they can augment the RT-PCR testing, so that the process that from the testing site to the lab, lab to testing site, this process is reduced and it is done mobile testing labs right where the sample is taken, there the testing can be done. Now, measures to improve the access and availability of testing. So there are some tests, you know, like rapid antigen test, as we already discussed, was recommended in June 2020. However, it was only limited to containment zones and healthcare settings. So now the ICMR is advising that to meet this overwhelming testing demand which we are currently facing, it is prudent to upscale the testing using rapid antigen test. So rapid antigen test may be allowed at all government and private healthcare facilities. Dedicated rapid antigen test booths should be set up in cities, towns, villages. Testing booths should be in multiple locations, healthcare facilities, RWA, office, schools, college, community centers, booths should be operational 24/7. Drive through rapid antigen test facilities should be set up, and strict measures should be taken that these places are not overcrowded. Additional advice, very important, symptomatic individuals identified positive for rapid antigen test should not be retested. They should be considered as positive. So rapid antigen positive is positive. You don't need to go for RT-PCR as per this additional advice given by ICMR. Symptomatic individuals identified by rapid antigen test. So for example, if somebody is symptomatic and the rapid antigen says that he is negative or she is negative, then he should be linked to a RT-PCR facility, but he should start his home isolation and all the treatments should start considering him corona positive. It says here that due to the current upsurge of corona 19 cases, any individual presenting with fever, with or without cough, headache, sore throat, breathlessness, body ache, recent loss of taste or smell, fatigue and diarrhea should be considered as a suspect case of COVID-19 unless proven otherwise by confirmation of another etiology. So, you know, then, so anybody who's filling the form for a RT-PCR or rapid antigen test must mention whether the person was vaccinated or not. So the major point of this whole thing is that rapid antigen tests have to be promoted. Anybody who is considered, you know, is having symptoms should be considered a positive patient unless proven otherwise. And anybody who has been rapid antigen positive should not go for a RT-PCR test. And another thing for the states, you know, there should be no requirement of testing because there is too much load. So there should be no requirement of testing between when there is interstate domestic travel. Thank you very much.